Today's video, we are going to take a look at the new features added to Photoshop 2026. We are going to test the AI models they have added. And also, we are going to compare the new updates with my plugin inside Photoshop and see which one wins. So, if you're ready, let's begin. Photoshop 2026 published a couple of days ago. And they have added a couple of new features, a couple of good things, and some of the new features they have added were added to Photoshop Beta some time ago, and they brought it now to Photoshop 2026. So here we are inside Photoshop. Here I open an image, and the size is, if we come to image size, the size is 330 by 411. Now, the first feature, which is really interesting and a lot of people paid attention to it, is the generative AI. So if we come here, if we make a selection in our image, if we click on generative fill, here they have added two new models. So previously we had Firefly here, now we have Flux, and we have Gemini 2.5, which is Nano Banana. So you can make a selection. There are two types. You can either come and select the brush tool, brush selection, and make a selection this way and write your prompt. You can write down, change the color of the shirt from yellow to, for example, red. Okay, now I'm gonna select my prompt and copy it and click on generate. Let's wait for a couple of seconds. Now, you should notice that these features, these new AI models, are not free. This is the pro version or premium version of Photoshop. And each time you generate a new image, it will cost you 10 credits. You can go to your Adobe account and look at the credits, the amount of credits that you have. And each time you generate a new image or some other features, it will cost between 10 to 20 credits. All right, the result is ready, but if you pay attention, the result is not very well. You see, here we have some cut and it's not placed correctly. If you just look at some of the places, if I turn it on and off, just look at here, you see, the result was misplaced. Now, this happens sometimes, not always, sometimes this happens from Nano Banana, but if the code is working correctly, the placement should be perfect. Now I'm going to show you my own plugin. Let me make the same selection. Okay. So we can compare it exactly. So I'm going to turn this layer off. And here we have the prompt that we wrote in the name of the layer. And here is my plugin. So if we come here, here we can write the prompt that we have. And we can select our AI model. I'm gonna select Nano Banana. And if I just press generate, now the difference here is that my plugin is connected to a website called Replicate. And each time you make a generation, each time that you generate an image or we make some changes, it will decrease from your credit on Replicate website. And it depends on the AI model. For example, C-Dream 4 here, each time you generate an image, it will cost you 3 cents, right? So neither on my plugin or on Adobe, generating images using these AI models, it's not free. So let's compare the result. This is the result we got from my plugin. Let me just close it. And this is the result we got from Adobe's Nano Banana. So if you look at it, in my version, it was placed exactly in the right place. And you can, it's hard to tell the difference from the original one, right? This is the part that I told you, the placement of the image is really important. And I spent a lot of time to perfect the placing part. When we get the result from AI model, clearly on Adobe, I have tested it a lot, not always, but from time to time, it has this issue. And also on Adobe version, they just add a mask layer based on your selection. which let me also try with the rectangle selection so you see that. So I'm just gonna come here again and make the same selection and come on generative fill, write the same prompt, and it is on Nano Banana. Let's click on generate. Again, we are spending 10 credit from our Adobe account. So I'm repeating this again because I got this question several times from my audience that, is it free? And the answer is no. So here's the result. You see it's very bad. It was placed really bad. And if you just compare it with my plugin result, you see it's much better. It was just in the right place, but comparing it with Adobe's Nano Banana, it's just bad. You have to just move it around until you find the correct position. I think we have to also just maybe change the size. It's really hard. Okay, I think I got it. No, I didn't. Anyway, it's bad. So this was the first update in the new Photoshop 2026. By the way, if you don't have the plugin, the link is down in the description. You can get the plugin. Also, I have added some related videos in the description to this plugin. So if you want to learn more about the plugin, you can just check out those videos as well. So let's continue. The next thing that they added is the upscale. So let me just go back to the original. So if we come here to the image, and here we have generative upscale. If I click on it, here we have Firefly upscaler, and we also have Topaz Gigapixel and Topaz Bloom. So these two are in the premium version, meaning you need to pay with credits. Okay, so if I click on Topaz Gigapixel, select 4x, here it will show you the resulting dimension. And one thing you should notice is that they will charge you, the price is a little bit different, the amount of credit that they will charge you. They will charge it based on the result that you got, not based on the image that you are sending. So if you turn on face recovery, it will improve the face a little bit. So let's look at the result. I'm going to click on upscale. It usually takes something around 10 to 20 seconds to generate these images. So I'm going to fast forward. All right, the image is ready. And one thing it does is that it will create, each time that you upscale, it will create a new file for you. So this is the result, as you can see, and this was the original. And if you pay attention, it's much better comparing to the original. We have a lot more details. It's not perfect, but it's much better, right? Just compare it. Now let's also, I want to show you the Adobe Firefly upscaler. So I'm just going to come back to generative upscale. Here we have Firefly upscaler 4 times and click on upscale. Now usually this is a little bit faster, but again, you should expect it from 10 to 20 seconds to get ready. All right, this one is also ready, and it's, if you compare it to the original, it's not much better. It's a little bit tiny, right? It's a little bit better. And if I want to show you what you can do on our plugin, so if we come here to our plugin and go to the pro version, here we have three models, three different AI models to do the upscale. We also have Topaz, we have Clarity, and we also have Crystal. Now this Crystal is super new. I just added it a couple of hours ago and works perfectly. You can upscale an image above 100 megapixel. It will cost you more, but it will give you this option to go that far and get the highest quality possible, which is amazing. So I'm gonna select Crystal, okay? And if I come to the setting, here there's a short explanation. For example, if your image is from 0 to 4 megapixel, the result that you want, it will cost you 5 cents. And as you go forward, it will get more expensive. So here we have a couple of options. We have 2x, 4x. And first, when you use this plugin, you need to make a selection. And now I'm gonna select 2x. And if you pay attention here, you can see the result. And based on the megapixel, it will tell you how much it will cost you. Now, if I go to my Replicate account, on my Replicate account, I have $18.44 credit. So if I just put it on 2 weeks, it will cost me 5 cents from my credit. Now I'm gonna just go crazy, right? And I'm gonna put it on 10x, right? And it will cost me 20 cents, but I want to show you the perfect result that you can get from it. I'm gonna click on generate and let's wait for the result. All right, it's ready, and it took about 10 to 12 seconds for the result to get ready. And the thing is that what you get here is you get the upscale here inside this file, okay? It will, if we check the history, it will get the image size. So if we go to image size here, now it is 10 times more. So let's look at the result. Let's look at the details and compare it with the original. So this was the original. This is the result we got. Look at the details. Look at the just little hair on his body and the sunlight hitting those hair. It's amazing. The details are crazy here, right? So this is the one of the good things that we just added to our plugin, and it's amazing, but it's inside the pro version. Now, if you want to compare it with the Adobe result, I'm just gonna get these and bring them here and just resize them, because there were 4x and this is 10x. Okay, and let's get this one as well. This is the Firefly upscaler. And let's just place them in the correct position. So here we have Topaz, we have Firefly, and we have Crystal upscale. So if I come here on the face, this is the original, this is Topaz, this is Firefly, and this is Crystal. Do you see the difference? It's amazing. Let's look at the hand. Let's compare the hand. So original, this is Firefly, this is Topaz, and this is Crystal, right? Let's look at the leg, the details on the leg and the hair. Oh my God, it's amazing. So the original, Topaz, Firefly, and Crystal. So as you can see, the Crystal model, which we just added to our plugin, is way, way better. And this is not the end. You can just keep going. For example, if I come to Crystal and make a selection here, and again, if I select 10x, now this will give me so high resolution, and it will cost me $3. So in case for some project or for something you need an image to be so high resolution, you have the option to go this far and get the best quality possible. But you should just pay attention to the price here so you don't spend the money that it's not needed, right? So the next feature they added is harmonize. So here I'm gonna bring an image of a ball, okay? I'm gonna just increase the size. We just put it somewhere around here. I think this size is more or less okay. So I'm gonna click on removing the background while I have selected this layer. And this is the result that we have. And now when you select it, here we have an option called harmonize, okay? So if I click on it, it tries to match the lighting and the shadows and the colors on the layer that you brought to the scene that you have, which is also really good. And I think this is also from the premium features of Photoshop, and it should cost you something around 10 to 20 credits. So the result is ready, and it will give us three options. Let me zoom in so you can see it's much better. So this is the result, the first one, second one, and the third one. I think the first one was fine. Okay, so this was the next feature. Another thing they added is that here now you have the ability to edit color and vibrance in one place. So here we have the temperature, right? We can make it warmer, add a little bit more green to it. You can do it in one place and maybe increase the vibrance a little bit. So this was the before, and after. Let's zoom back a little so we can see the whole image. Before, after. So these were the new updates in Photoshop 2026. And while we are here, I can show you something cool we just added to our plugin. And we are adding a prompt library. And right now we have added 10 prompts, right? And here you can see the result of them. And all you need to do, this is prompt library. We have developed high quality prompts, great prompts that give you the perfect result that you need in different cases. And you can either just click on run and get the result directly, or you can click on modify. So for example, I can come here and let's just take the ball out of the picture. Okay. So I'm going to select the whole image, right? And let's say if I click on modify, it will jump here. It will select the AI model. And if I want to make some changes, change some colors or add something or remove something from the prompt, I can do it. But if I want to just directly run it, I can come here, select my image and click on run. And let's look at the result together. The result is ready and it looks amazing. Look at it. I really like this prompt. You can add it to your own portrait. You can add it to your own images. I have done it before with my image. And it looks really amazing. So there are many different prompts here that you can use. And as we go forward with the future updates, we try to add more professional prompts to this prompt library on the other side of adding new AI models to the plugin and so on. So if you get the plugin, you also will get the future updates as well. So in case if you don't have the plugin, the link to the plugin is down in the description. You can get it from there. And if you are interested in this kind of videos, please do not forget to like and leave a comment. If you have a question, if you face some issues, if you face some problems, you can always leave a comment. If you have some ideas or some suggestions, I'm happy to hear it. And I do my best to read all the comments that you write for me. Of course, if you are not subscribed, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell so the new videos that comes out, you don't miss them. Also, if we publish a new update for our plugin, I will always announce it here on my YouTube channel, and also we will send a link to our members. So that was all for this video. I hope you liked it, and I look forward to see you soon on the next video.